Good morning, PBC. Ken and I just love you all so much. We miss you, and we're looking forward to your return. And if you're an alumni listening to this or a future student, please know that our hearts are with you, and we're keeping you all in prayer. You, your families, and your friends. We're only a text away, so don't hesitate to message us, to Marco Polo, to text, to email, to whatever, send messages on Populi. We love you. Our hearts are with you. Today in this devotional, I just want to take a few minutes and give you a few reminders. Reminders that you've already learned in Life of Christ class, reminders that Jesus gave to his disciples when they were stepping into their most stressful season of their time, and he was stepping into his most stress-filled season when he was on the earth. And in Luke 22 and verse 19, he said to his disciples, "When you do this, what we're about to do, I want you to remember me." And he wanted them to remember him. I think he wanted them to be reminded every time that they would do this. And of course, this was the sitting at Passover meal and breaking bread with him. And he did four things with bread that he always did. Every time you read of Jesus in the Gospels breaking bread, whether it was on a hillside or whether it was in someone's home, like he was at this time having a Passover meal with his disciples, he always did the same four things with bread. And so today I want to remind you of those four things and just share with you again to remind you in these stressful times. And I'm going to give you a few tips of perhaps that will help you to handle any stress or anxiety that you may be feeling. We know that the Lord doesn't want us to be anxious for anything, but to trust him in all things. And so let's just look at what he did in Luke 22 and verse 19. The first thing that he did was he took it. He was taken by the Father. He was chosen by the Father to come to earth at this particular time in history. And you know what? You have been chosen at this time by your Heavenly Father to be here on planet Earth. And He wants you to know that He has chosen you for a specific purpose. And so keep your whole person in tune with the Holy Spirit during this season. Keep your whole person in tune with Him, spirit, soul, and body. In your spirit, keep your daily connection with Jesus real. Keep it raw, keep it real, keep it honest, keep it real with Him. Psalm 46, verses 1 and 2 says that God is our refuge. He is our help in times of trouble. He's not afraid of what you might write in your journal or what you might say to him in your devotional time. So keep it real with Jesus. This is the way to keep your spirit real. I would encourage you, if you're a journaler, journal. Journal your thoughts, journal your prayers. And I would encourage each one of you to write a list of gratitude and each day write at least one thing that you are grateful for, one person, one thing, something that you are grateful for. And just thank the Lord each day for something new, something fresh that He will bring to your mind, even if you are in a season of grieving right now because perhaps you've lost someone to the coronavirus. Maybe you know someone who has it right now and has been diagnosed and they're fearful. Keep a list of prayers and turn those intercessions into times of praise and times of the good memories, times of the positive, what you believe in Him that He's going to do for these. One thing that one author said was, "For peace of mind, resign as the general manager of the universe." I want to encourage you to give the universe back to God. Only God is in charge of this. Only God knows what He's going to do. You are chosen, and He has something for you today. He has something for you tomorrow, and He has something for you in the future. He's chosen you for this time and this season. So keep your spirit remembering that you are chosen for a specific purpose, and keep your soul and body. when we're chosen, we keep ourselves healthy, not only in our spirit, but in our souls and in our bodies. So exercise your mind, exercise your body. Be studying the Bible, be reading the Bible, be memorizing. This is a great time to memorize verses. Keep your mind sharp. Nothing sharper than the two-edged sword of the Word of God. So keep yourself in the Word. Keep yourself stimulated by reading other good books. Keep your mind sharp. Keep your body sharp. Go out for a walk. Go out for a jog. Come on, get yourself up and get yourself out. The Lord's chosen you and He wants you to stay healthy. Keep your body, you know, have good sleep. Not only do you want your soul to come to a place of peace and rest, but get enough sleep for you. Not the kind of sleep that leads you into isolation and escape and depression, but get enough sleep and rest in this season. Rest, laugh, play, sleep enough for you. But be awake to the reality that He has chosen you. He took the bread. He chose the bread. He chose Jesus. He's chosen you. The second thing Jesus always did with bread was He blessed it. He gave thanks for it. And of course, this is a reminder to us that He is the blessed one. He is the anointed one. And I want to remind you today, just as Jesus was reminding His disciples, you are blessed. And you are not only chosen, but you're blessed and anointed by Him. So be in tune to the voice of the Holy Spirit. Listen to the Holy Spirit every day. He wants to come and encourage you. He wants to tell you what to do and what to say and who to get connected with. You know, I want to remind you all, you are not alone. We are all in this together, every single one of us. We're in this together. Though we're apart physically, we are together in heart and in soul and in spirit. So don't get connected. We have physical distance, but do not let yourself have relational difference. Stay connected. Lean in. Don't lean away. Give prayer. Ask for prayer. For those of you students who are still in the dorm at this time, step outside of your dorm room. Everybody step outside at the same time and begin to sing, begin to worship, begin to share with one another a prayer request, a prayer need. Begin to share with one another a scripture of encouragement. You know, and those of you who are at home, maybe you're in quarantine. I know some of you are in a two-week quarantine right now, and some of you are in shelter like we are here in Oregon. Wherever you are, send a message to one another. Stay connected. Stay connected. Jesus has blessed you. He has anointed you. He wants you to give one another prophetic encouragements. Stay encouraged. The third thing that Jesus always did with bread was He broke it. We know that He was broken for us. And we know that there'll be times like this, not only now, but times even in the future when we will be challenged. And we shouldn't be surprised by times of brokenness, but we should realize that He comes to give us strength even in times of brokenness and times of challenge. The fourth thing that Jesus always did with the bread was He gave it. So He chose it because He was the chosen one and He's chosen you. He blessed it because He was the blessed one, the anointed one, and you are anointed today. He broke it as a symbol that He was to be broken for us, and we are not to be surprised by seasons of challenge. And the last thing was He always gave it, and that's because He was given for us, of course, and we are to be given to others. So can I ask you this? I'm going to ask you this. Don't just be a college student. Be the church. You're not just a Bible college student. You are the church. So reach out, find a need, and meet a need. Maybe the Lord wants you to pray for someone. So get on social media and the variety of kinds of ways that we can today and pray for someone. Pray and encourage someone every day. Get on it. And don't be on so long that you get stressed by everything that's on and you get weary and stressed from being on so much. But get on every day and meet a need. Find a need and meet a need. Edify others with your gifts and with your talents. Get on and give others words of encouragement, prophetic insight, words of knowledge, words of wisdom. I'm just glancing here at my notes. Give others songs, you know. Play your instruments and sing a song for us. We're ready to hear it. Write a song. Maybe one of your gifts and talents is photo art. Come on, please post that for us. Come and edify us with your photo art. You know, take a picture of yourself smiling and just post it for the rest of us to be encouraged by, or find something that makes you smile and take a picture of it so that, and then post that for us to see. Let's send smiles to one another, things that make us smile, and even smiling faces. Let's start something here with our smiles. If you're talented with, you know, sketching or painting or watercolors or sketching or calligraphy, do that. Calligraphy some scriptures and take a picture of it and post it for us all. If you're, I know some of you students have great humor. Keep it appropriate, of course, but, you know, send us some funny things. I've seen some really funny memes going around, and it just edifies you and gives you a moment of laughter in this time. Get out if you're able to and mow a lawn for a senior citizen. Offer to go get their groceries for them if you're healthy and strong. You know, do something for someone. Create order in, you know, around you. If you're in the dorms, get up, clean your room, do some deep cleaning. If you're at home, offer to do some deep cleaning for your parents and get up. And, you know, chaos around us adds chaos to our souls. And we don't need more chaos in our souls right now, you all. So let's give order as a gift to those around us. You know, give a smile. Like I said, you know, I just want to remind you in closing here, you are stronger than perhaps you think that you are. Give the gift of strength and encouragement to someone today. I want to close by telling you all that you are loved. Ken and I love you. The staff here, we all love you. We are so grateful for you in our lives. You are gifts to us, and we just love you so very much. Jesus loves you. We love you. You are not alone. We are in this together. I want to close in prayer. Father, I thank you so much for each and every person listening to this recording today. I pray, Lord God, that we would remember that you've chosen us, and that you've anointed us, and we're not going to be surprised by this season of challenge. And Lord, we remember that just as you were given, we are to be given for others. So Lord, make us brave today and give us wisdom in how we can go about in the way that we can today. Though we are separate, we are together. So let us be given for the sake of the harvest today, and for the sake of one another. Let us build each other up today. In Jesus' name, we dedicate this time to you, Lord, and for the rest of our day and evening. In your name, Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen. God bless you all. Love you so much.